The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 17, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 11th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Although the super soul appears to be divided, he is never divided. He is situated as one. Although he is the maintainer of every living entity, it is to be understood that he devours and develops all.
Avivaktam cha bhute. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddheshe arjuna tishtati. This is another statement of Bhagavad Gita, that the Lord, Supreme Lord, He is situated in everyone's heart. Riddhesa, particularly pointed out. Riddhesa means in the heart. Rid means heart. So modern medical science, they see that the energy is coming from the heart. And as soon as the heart stops to work, it is saying that the body is dead. So here also the same thing is confirmed. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddheshe arjuna tishtati. They cannot say, explain why the heart stops. But here we get the explanation that as soon as the soul, both the soul and the super soul, leave this body, then it is only a lump of matter. It is nowhere. Thus thou art, thus thou beest. It is developed from this material elements, five gross elements and three subtle elements. But so long it was, as long as the soul, the spirit soul, and the super soul remains. The soul and the super soul, it is stated in the Vedic literature, Upanishad, they are sitting in one branch of the tree, together as friends. The soul and the super soul, both of them are within the heart. But the soul is now looking forward for material enjoyment. And the super soul is witnessing the material activities of the individual soul. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Anuvanta upadrashta. Upadrashta means overseeing. For every action we are doing, there is witness. That is karmavar, witness. Suppose one man has done something wrong in the penal court, one requires witness, either to punish him or to release him. The witness required. So witness is there. The Supreme Personality of Godhead as Paramatma, He is there as witness. Anuvanta upadrashta. Anuvanta means without the sanction of the Paramatma, the individual soul cannot do anything. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Sarvasya chaham ridhisandhi nishtya. I am sitting in everyone's heart. Sarvasya chaham ridhisandhi nishtya. Matta smriti jnanam apuhanamcha. Through me, everyone is getting remembrance, smriti, jnana, knowledge, and everyone is forgetting also. That is due to this Paramatma or super soul. We are now in forgotten state. This condition, material life, means we have forgotten our real constitutional position. I am thinking I am this body. But I am not this body. I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi. But we have forgotten. We have forgotten our relationship with the Supreme Lord. This forgetfulness is also due to the influence of the Super Soul. Because we wanted to act just like a very first-class dramatic director, he instructs the player in such a way that sometimes he forgets. The more he forgets, he plays very nice. Similarly, we wanted to enjoy this material world. So unless you forget completely that I am spirit soul, I am not this body, actually I cannot enjoy. So that forgetfulness is also due to the super soul. He is giving us full chance. But his advice is that do not be entangled in this material activity. Therefore, his instruction is sarva-dharmān paritya mām ekam saraṇam. That is his instruction. But we do not want that. We want to forget and entangle ourselves in these material activities. Therefore, Krishna, by the agency of his māyā, illusory energy, helps us in forgetting. But if we want to revive our original consciousness, then also Krishna helps you. Buddhi-yogam dadāmitam, that is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Tesham satatujuttānam bhajatāṁ apriti-bhūrbhakam dadāmi buddhi-yogam tam jīna-māmukhijāntite. So two things, we are at liberty, we have to make our choice. If we want to enjoy this material world, Krishna will provide all facilities you can enjoy. But Krishna says that you will never be happy, never be happy. You will be simply more entangled. More entangled means, now I have got this human form of body, but according to my desire at the time of death, I may get another body, which may not be human form of body. There are 8,400,000 species and forms of body. I can get one of them. These are very subtle things. One has to understand it. Jamjanga bhāpi saram bhāvam tajattante kalevaram. At the time of death, our next body will be decided according to my mental condition. So, entanglement means, today I am thinking I have got this body, Indian body or American body or English body or this body, fat body, thin body. Tomorrow I may not possess. As soon as I get another body, that means the chapter changes. If I get a body of a dog, then I act like a dog. If I get the body of a hog, then I act like a hog. And if I get the body of a god, and god is a demigod, has standard of life, then you can act like that. The body is the destiny. With the body, everything is destiny. Material happiness and distress, everything, that is called adrishta. Adrishta means which you cannot see, but it has been fixed up by superior intelligence, that this much you will get. Therefore we see so many divisions of status. One man is working very hard day and night, but it is very difficult for him to collect even so much money that I can eat very nicely. Because the body is made for that. Similarly, another man born with silver spoon in the mouth, he hasn't got to try very much, but he gets his money quickly, very quickly. Therefore, the Bhagavad says that don't waste your time for so-called happiness and distress. Don't waste your time. because you are already destined to receive a standard of happiness and distress. You cannot change. But you can change your consciousness, that is possible. But you cannot change your material position. The modern people, they do not know. They do not know it, that material condition, it cannot be changed. Take for example, that a pig, his body is meant for eating stool. So you cannot induce him to eat halwa, that cannot. He will not accept. Because the body is meant like. But in the human form, if we change our consciousness, then we can revive our original status. Original status means eternal life or blissfulness and knowledge. That is original life. Satchitananda vigraha. So that super soul is always helping us as friend. Therefore here it is said, avivaktam ca bhuteshu. Avivaktam ca bhuteshu vivaktam yuvata sthitam. The super soul appears like an individual soul, he is staying as friend, so he has been divided. Vivaktam viva, as if divided. It is not divided. The example you can understand. Just like there is sun on the sky, and if you keep millions of pots with water, you will find the sun is reflected there. That does not mean the sun has divided into millions. This is the best example. There are millions of people standing at 12 o'clock. And you ask every one of them, even 5,000 miles away, where is the sun? Everyone will say, it is on my head. Does it mean the sun has divided into millions of persons and on each head stands standing? No. Sun is one. But it appears like that. Therefore it is said that avivaktam ca bhuteshu vivaktam iva asthitam. He is not vibhakta. Ishara sarva bhutanam desa arjuna tisthati. Ishara, the Supreme Lord, has super soul, is staying in everyone's heart. That does not mean he has become divided. No, he is one. That is already explained. That sarva khetre subhara. Khetram mancha vimana vidhi. Sarva khetre subhara. Krishna said that in each and every individual body there is the soul, khetra gram. This body is khetra, field of activities. And within the body, the soul is there. He is working according to the position. He is working. So he is khetra gram. Just because I know it is my body. I don't say it is I body. No, I say my body. You say my body. Everyone says, I know this is my body. If I see my finger, I think it is my finger. I don't think I finger. Because I am not this body. Anyone, simply little sober thinking. So therefore, the one who knows that it is my body, he is Khetragya. He knows. And the body is called Khetragya. Idam sarīram khetram meti obhidhiyate. This sarīr is called khetra, field of activities. According to my body, I am acting. That is my field of activity. And Krishna says also that khetram manchapi māgavidhi sarva khetri jubha. He says, I am a living entity. I am soul. I know the business of my body. The pains and pleasure of my body I know. But the pains and pleasure of your body I do not. Neither you know my pains and pleasure. So you are all individual. But it is another proprietor. Actually he is the proprietor. He is the proprietor, we are simply occupier. Just like of a house, there are two persons. One is the proprietor of the house, another tenant is the occupier of it. So we are simply occupier. The real proprietor is Krishna. Sarva khetre subharat. Khetra manchati imana. That is Ishara Sarvabhuta. He knows, everyone, what you are doing. Not only I, you, everyone. Therefore it is stated, that Supreme Person, Brahma, avivittam ca bhuteshu, he is staying in everyone's heart. That is Krishna. Just like I am sitting here, I am not in my apartment. You are sitting here, you are not in your apartment, because you are limited. But Krishna, although he is living in his Goloka Vrindavan planet, he is everywhere. That is already explained yesterday, I have already discussed. Bahirantastra bhutanam acharam charamayvata sukhattam sarvata pani padastat sarvatokshi sirumukham. We have discussed all this. That is Krishna, that is God. He is in his, that is confirmed in the Ishopanishad. Ishavasvainam sattvam yatkinchit jagatyanyam tena tat tena mutha. So, everywhere is Krishna, everywhere is God. Sarvato upani pāta. He has got hands and legs everywhere. And because he has got hands everywhere, therefore, when you offer something to Krishna or God with faith and love, he can accept. Not that because he is far, far away, therefore, I am offering here something with faith and love, he cannot accept. No, he can accept. Just like a bank can accept your deposit from any branch. Immediately, your account is credit. Similarly, in the Brahma Samhita it is said, Golokoeva nivasati okilatma bhuto. That is Krishna, that is God. That he is always existing in his abode. But okilatma bhuto. At the same time, he is existing everywhere within the creation. Annantarasthanga paramanachayantarasthanga. That some philosophers attain, saying that he is everywhere, but he is not in his abode. That is mistake. Purnasa purnamadaya purnamavya avishvishtate. In his fullness, if he is presented everywhere, he is still in his fullness, he is in his abode. It's like, I am not in fullness in my apartment. Maybe there's some message I can read, but I'm not in fullness. But Krishna, God, can remain everywhere in fullness. Akhilatmanji, Golokaeva nivasati, Akhilatmanji. So, that is Krishna consciousness perception. And he is living, because he is a Mayavadi philosopher, they are accepting that Krishna or Parabrahma or God, because he is in everywhere, he has no personality. That is a poor kind of knowledge. That is not God. Because we are thinking material. Just like if I take a piece of paper and tear it into small pieces and throw it, then the original paper has no existence. This is called Mayavad. Mayavad or imperfect knowledge. Because I am thinking that materially, if one thing is broken into pieces and thrown, the original form is lost. No. It becomes impersonal. No. The Veda says that purnasya purnameva adaya purnameva vasishyati. You take the full, God full. Even God fully represented in every atom, still is full. that 1 minus 1 equal to 1 and 1 plus 1 equal to 1. That is absolute idea. But we calculate from materialistic point of view, as we have got our teeny brain, we think like that. Therefore, Jiva Goswami said, unless you accept inconceivable power of the Supreme Lord, you cannot understand God. That is not possible. If you compare with your conceivable power, the God may be like this. That Dr. Frog's calculation of the Atlantic Ocean. That's a story you know. Frog philosopher. The frog lives within the well and he is calculating the length and breadth of Atlantic Ocean. How is this possible? It is not possible. So we are frogs in the well. We have got limited capacity to understand. Our senses are limited. We are thinking Krishna or God also, He is also limited. This is our fault. This is called poor fund of knowledge. You cannot compare with God. But Mahabharata philosophers speculate like that and spoil their own time and spoil others. But that is not possible.
Avivaktam ca bhuteshu vivaktam ivata sthitam bhuta bhatri ca tad geyam gasesno prabhavishnu ca.
He is giving all the necessities, the Supreme Lord. He is giving all the necessities of every living entity. Eka jo bahunam vidadhati kama. This is Vedic instruction. Upanishad. Nityanam chetana chetanana ekoja bahunam vidadhatikama. There are two eternals and two living entities. One is plural number, nityanam, this is plural number. And nitya, that is singular number, nitya nityanam. The Lord is also a living entity. Just like we are living entity, we have got our senses. Similarly, God has also senses, but His senses are not limited. Our senses are limited. That is the difference. So nitya nityanam chetana chetananam. But what is the difference between the singular number and plural number? The eka, singular number, jo vidhati kama. Bahuna. And actually, God is feeding us. You find in Africa there are millions of elephants. Who is giving them food? In your home, within the hole, you find millions of ants. Are you giving them food? Who is giving them food? There are so many birds and beasts. There is no ration, government ration for them. They are eating. No bird we have seen ever that it has died out of starvation. We have never experienced. But we are engaged in philanthropy, what? To give food to the poor. As if God is unable to give food to the poor. Because we are taking the position of God. So this is not our business. God has food for everyone. If one is suffering, that is his own fault. That's why in the hospital, you go, you'll find so many patients are starving. Does it mean the patients are starving for want of food? No. He must starve, otherwise he will not be cured. That is destiny. So, these are not our business to see. Our own business is how to revive our original consciousness.